We're here with freshman linebacker Hamilton Anoa'i and redshirt freshman linebacker Ray Davison. How you guys doing?
Doing well.
Fine, thank you.
So you are both contributing fairly early in your collegiate careers, had a decent amount of playing time so far this year. Ray, you had a year to learn the defense and then kind of relearn it again with a new staff this year. Do you feel like that redshirt year made you a little bit more confident and physically developed to come into this year and make an impact?
I would say so, yes, because kind of just as a redshirt freshman, you get to see like the intensity and see what the speed is going to be like, kind of just playing at the college level. Coming from high school, it's definitely not the same. It's a lot faster. And kind of just watching older guys, you pick up on their tendencies and keys, and you kind of just try to mimic what they do and try to do what they do better. So I would say so, yes.
And how's the transition been from defensive end to linebacker?
It went pretty smoothly. At first, I was kind of upset because nothing better than getting a sack at the end, but kind of just it's better for me as far as my size playing linebacker. I can move better and kind of just get over blocks and things like that.
And Hamilton, you also made a move. You played safety and you've played tight end and a lot of positions, but you're playing linebacker now. How's that transition been for you?
You know, I'll give all the credit to the older guys around me who's helped make their contributions to my transition as well as coach. I'm not going to say it was easy. But you know, with the guys around me, they made it easier, you know, making that transition.
So I was asking Coach Sash about the possibility of you playing a little safety since they're so short back there, but he said you've kind of outgrown that position now physically. So yeah. How big are you right now?
I'm about 6'2", 225.
Okay. So the hitting part would probably come naturally. The coverage part may be a little bit difficult with your increased size. So you guys have a lot of similarities. You both come from Catholic schools, with Ray with you from Crestby Carmelite and Hamilton with you from Sarah. Has that colored the way that you you carry yourselves as individuals at all? Has it helped shape you? Do you see similarities?
I'd say just a little bit, not too much. I mean, for me, the biggest thing going to Catholic school is strengthening my faith with just my religion. And I think like that coming from high school, I definitely carry that part of my life into college. You know, just always ready to put God first and you know things like that. I'd say that was the biggest contribution that I brought from my Catholic high school into Cal. So
I would say so too. You can kind of tell the guys who kind of went to Catholic schools or private schools, not just kind of just by their demeanor and kind of their mannerisms, and even sometimes to me by their play. Like you can tell like a guy that went to like De La Salle or Notre Dame or Loyola or Sarah. So you can kind of tell.
The other similarity is that you both were Northwestern commits and you both ended up at Cal. How did it work out?
I mean, kind of just when you come to Cal, I kind of knew from the start when I got here. My host was Chris Harper, and he was one of my teammates in high school, and kind of just walking around campus and just seeing the energy and just knowing it's the number one public institution in the world. I mean, it's really a no-brainer.
You know, same as Ray, you know, once comparing the two schools, it's not too hard to make a decision. Me, growing up here from the Bay Area, you know, I've made a couple of Cal games, you know, growing up in my childhood, and I've always liked the energy around this campus and everything. You know, one of my dreams growing up was always to play in the Pac-12, so once the offer came around, I couldn't resist, and I jumped on it.
Was it strange having Northwestern on the calendar, on the schedule?
Oh, not at all. I was excited.
I was excited.
Fitzgerald gave you a little bit of crap when you made your move, right?
Definitely.
But it must have been sweet to turn things around this year and to do it in there at their home field, too.
It was. Nothing better.
Well, what are you looking forward to this week coming up against UCLA? What are you seeing looking at the film?
You know, just another tough team. You know, everybody in the Pac-12 is hard, but I'd say the rest of our schedule, you know, we can't let up. We're going to have to keep getting better. And, you know, for me personally, I'm excited to get back out there with my boys and bounce back from this loss that we just came from. So,
well, I would say so, too. Like you said, UCLA is a good team, but we're going to focus on ourselves and kind of work on what we do and just kind of just getting better each week. But it's going to be an interesting week. It's going to be a lot of fun.
Okay. Thanks for taking the time to talk, and good luck this weekend.